Hi, my name is Dan Davis, and I'm a D&B home mortgage, and today I'm here to discuss the FHA loan process and how the FHA loan process differs from the conventional loan process from a real estate agent's perspective. So you're a real estate agent, you get a pre-qualification letter from your buyer. It states that you're FHA, but you're pre-qualified for an FHA loan, you're pre-approved for an FHA loan. What do you need to know from that point moving forward on FHA loans? So the one main thing that you need to know that's different between an FHA and a conventional loan is that an FHA loan requires an additional addendum slash amendatory clause. What this amendatory clause is it protects your buyers if the appraised value of the home is less than the purchase price of the home. Basically, it gives your buyers an out to get their earnest money deposit back if the buyers and sellers can't come to terms after the appraised value comes in below the purchase price. That's the one main difference. Now, I want to kind of go over some of the real estate agents' areas of their concerns, some myths that we hear all the time. Oh, I'm scared of FHA loans because of X, Y, and Z. The first thing we hear a lot is FHA requires pest inspections, FHA requires water tests for homes with wells. That's purely a myth. The FHA guidelines don't require water tests, they don't require pest inspections. We have heard that there are certain lenders out there that require their own water tests and their own pest inspection for FHA loans, but it's not an FHA guideline. And here at D&B Home Mortgage, we don't have additional overlays such as pest inspection and water tests for our FHA buyers. Two, closing dates are delayed. We hear all the time, I don't want to accept an FHA offer because the closing is going to get delayed. That's just not true. Our FHA loans are getting cleared to close in between 20 and 25 days, and closing typically happening or averaging about 30 days, which is the same as a conventional loan. So as you can see, there's really no difference in the process, so the closing time shouldn't get delayed, and it isn't. Number three, appraisals are too strict. We hear this all the time. Oh, I don't want to accept an FHA offer because, you know, the appraisals, this house isn't going to come back with a positive appraisal, all this stuff, it's too old. Well, we have not seen many issues with FHA appraisals. And here I want to kind of go over six rule of thumb for FHA appraisals to make sure that you won't have issues with FHA appraisals. One, all appliances that convey must be functional. Basically, any appliance that comes with the house must be able to work, must be able to turn on and off. Doesn't mean that you have to have stainless steel appliances or that appliances have to be brand new, but the ones that convey with the house need to work. Two, AC needs to be functional. The air conditioner, again, doesn't have to be brand new, but it does need to run. It does need to cool the home and needs to be functional. Number three, the water and the electric need to work. So again, the appraiser is going to test and make sure the faucets or the water's coming out of the faucets, that the water and the electric's working. Nothing crazy there, but the water and electric have to work. Number four, this one's a little bit more specific. The hot water heater must have a relief valve with pipe going down to the floor. Now, that's a very specific requirement. That being said, we've never seen an issue with that, and most hot water heaters have this requirement. Number five, attic needs visible insulation. So this is one difference between an FHA appraisal and a conventional appraisal. FHA appraiser is required to take a picture of the attic, and the attic needs to have visible insulation. Again, we haven't seen issues with this, but it is one additional thing that you need to think about for FHA appraisal. Number six, main dwelling needs to be safe. So again, it says main dwelling needs to be safe. It does not say the main dwelling needs to be new. We get questions all the time. I have a really old home or an older home. It's in really good shape. What do you think will that pass an FHA appraisal? We do 1950s, 1960s homes all the time. We finance 1950s, 1960s homes that are in good shape, and they have no issues with FHA appraisals. As long as the home is safe, again, it doesn't need to be new, it just needs to be safe. Lastly, I want to go over three scenarios where you're not going to want to accept. If you're listening, you're not going to want to accept an FHA offer. One, condos. FHA does not finance condos other than the few FHA approved condos that you can find on the FHA website. But as a general rule of thumb, FHA does not finance condos. Number two, FHA has a flip rule. If the sellers own the home for 90 days or less, you cannot get FHA financing on it. You're going to want to go conventional. Three, the loan limit. The FHA loan limit in Lee County is 275, 665. If you have a house that's listed at $450,000 and you have a buyer with an FHA approval at $450,000, something's probably wrong. The loan officer probably didn't know the loan limit. Something's probably wrong. You're not going to want to accept the offer. You're going to get a lot more details from that buyer to see, does he truly have a $200,000 down payment, or did the loan officer mess up and write this $450,000 FHA pre-qualification? If you have any questions about FHA financing, VA financing, conventional financing, jumbo financing, please feel free to give me a call at 239 834-0494, or you can call our office line at 239-307-LEND to get any more additional details about FHA financing or any other financing you may be interested in. Thank you very much and have a great day.